माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर रोहित कुमार फ्रॉम IIMS नोएडा. दिस वीडियो प्रिपेयर फॉर द ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड कॉन्सेप्ट विद जावा. वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ जावा, व्हाट इज द यूज्ड ऑफ जावा, फीचर्स ऑफ जावा, जावा प्रोग्राम ट्रांसलेशन, JVM, ओवरव्यू एंड डेवलपमेंट फेज, एडवांटेज एंड डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ जावा एंड प्रोजेक्ट. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल we will discuss what is the meaning of the java. java is a object oriented programming language as well as platform. java was developed by a team led by james gosling at sun microsystems. java is a first programming language which provide the concept of writing program that can be executed using the web. where is java used? according to the sun, 3 billion devices run Java. There are many devices where Java is currently used. There are most important 3 applications. First is desktop application. Second is web application. Third is enterprise application. Desktop application example is Acrobat Reader, Media Player, Antiviruses, etc. Web application example is irctc.co.in, javapoint.com, etc. Enterprises application is banking application, business application, mobile application, embedded system, games and robotics. These are the used in Java at the time. Features of Java. Java is a simple and object oriented platform. Java is distributed. Java is architecture neutral. Java is robust and interpreted and compiled. Java is secure and portable. Java is multi-threaded. These are the features of Java. Java program translation. I want to create a first program in Java. That is, I want to save this file hello.java. .java is an extension of the file of Java. This is the source code. And compiler name of Java compiler is Java C. And Java compiler compile this source code and convert into the bytecode. And this file is stored on the disk hello.class. Hello.class, this is the bytecode of the source file after the compilation. There are hello.class run different type of the operating system, just as Win XP, Mac, Unix. So Java is an independent language. Independent language. Okay. What is the meaning of JVM? JVM means Java Virtual Machine. Java Virtual Machine is the like usual computer which translate high level language into machine language. What is the meaning of the high level language? This is the English language, and machine language is a binary language, that is 0 and 1. So we will write the code of Java in high level language, just like as an English language. And compiler JVM convert the source code. JVM convert the high level language into the machine language, just as 0 and 1. Just like that, Java Virtual Machine also translate bytecode into the machine language. JVM are available for many hardware and software platforms. What is OOP means object oriented programming? Object oriented programming is a method of implementation, a language in which everything present in the form of object is called object oriented programming language. It not only make the program less complex, but also make the software use feasible and possible. Java is not truly object-oriented programming language. Concept of OOPs. First is object. Second is class. Third is encapsulation. Fourth is inheritance. Fifth is polymorphism. And last is abstraction. apart from these concepts, there are some other terms which are used in object-oriented device, that is coupling, cohesion, association, aggregation, and composition. So first of all, what is the meaning of the object? Object means a real world entity such as a pen, chair, table, computer, watch, etc. Object-oriented programming is a methodology or paradigm to design a program using classes and objects. It simplifies software development and maintenance by providing some concept. First is object. Any entity that has a state and behavior is known as object. For example, a chair, pen, table, keyboard, bike, etc. It can be visible or logical. An object can be defined as an instance of a class. An object contains an addresses and take up some space in memory. Object can communicate without knowing the detail of each other data or code. The only necessary things is the type of message accepted and the type of response written by the objects. Example, a dog is an object because it has a state like color, name, breed, etc., as well as behaviors like wagging the tail, barking, eating, etc. So these are most important two things, states and behavior. What is the meaning of the class? Collection of object is called class. It is logical entity. A class can also be defined as a blueprint from which you can create an individual object. Class does not consume any space. And next is encapsulation. Binding or wrapping code and data together into a single unit are known as encapsulation. For example, a capsule, it is wrapped with different medicines. A Java class is the example of encapsulation. Java Bean is the fully encapsulated class because all the data members are private here. Next is inheritance. When one object acquires all the properties and behavior of a parent object, it is known as inheritance. It provides code reusability. It is used to achieve runtime polymorphism. That is the meaning of inheritance. Next is polymorphism. If one task is performed in different ways, it is known as polymorphism. For example, to convince the customer differently, to draw something. For example, shape, triangle, rectangle, etc. In Java, we use method overloading and method overwriting to achieve polymorphism. Another example can be speak something. For example, a cat speak meow, dog bark woof, etc. But these are the animals. And animals is cat and dog. And last is abstraction, hiding internal details and showing functionality is known as abstraction. For example, phone call, we don't know the internal processing. In Java, we use abstract class and interface to achieve abstraction. Apart from the object-oriented feature, that is coupling. Coupling refers to the knowledge or information or dependency of another class. It arises when classes are aware of each other. If a class has the detailed information of another class, there is a strong coupling. In Java, we use private, protected, and public modifiers to display the visibility level of a class, method, and field. You can use interfaces for the weaker coupling because there is no concentrated implementation. Next is cohesion. Cohesion refers to the level of a component which perform a single well-defined task. A single well-defined task is done by a highly cohesive method. Highly cohesive method. The weakly cohesive method will split the task into separate parts. The java.io package is a highly cohesive package because it's the input-output relative classes and interface. However, the java.util package is a weakly cohesive package because it has unrelated classes and interfaces. And last is association. Association represents the relationship between the objects. Here, one object can be associated with one object or many objects. There can be four types of association between the objects: one to one, one to many, many to one, and many to many. Let's understand the relationship with real time example. For example, one country can have one prime minister, that means one to one, and a prime minister can have many ministers, one to many. Also, many MPs can have one prime minister, that is the example of many to one, and many ministers can have many departments, that is the example of the many to many. Association can be undirectional or bidirectional. This is the important. Aggregation. Aggregation is a way to achieve association. Aggregation represents the relationship where one object contains other object as a part of its state. It represents the weak relationship between object. It is also termed as has a relationship in Java. Like inheritance represents the is a relationship. It is another way to reuse objects. Next is composition. The composition is also a way to achieve association. The composition represents the relationship where one object contains another object as a part of its state. There is a strong relationship between the containing object and the dependent object. It is the state where containing object do not have an independent existence. If you delete the parent object, all the child object will be deleted automatically. That is the meaning of the composition. It is clear? Next is Java system overview. There are three parts of Java system overview. First is operating system. Second is Java programming language. And third is Java application. Java programming language further divided into three parts. First is Java native interface. Second is Java class library. And third is Java virtual machine. Further, Java virtual machine. First part is class loader, second part is verifier, and third part is execution. That is the overview of Java system. Java program development phases. There are five phases. Phase one is edit, phase two compiler, phase three load, phase four verify, and phase five execute. Phase one is edit, that means program create and store on disk as .java extension file. That is the first phase is edit. Phase two compiler means bytecode creates and store on disk as dot class file. Phase three load means class loader reads bytecodes from disk and put it in memory. That's like as a primary memory. And phase fourth is verify. Verify means bytecode verifier verify the validation and check whether it violates Java security restriction. And last is execute. Execute means JVM Java Virtual Machine reads bytecode and compiles them into machine language. This is the complete phases of Java programming development. These are the data type in Java. There are two types of Java data types, non-primitive data types and primitive data types. This is the, we will create completely video based on data type in Java. So, but only for the go through in this video, there are two types of the data types. Non-primitive data type. Non-primitive data type is array, class, and interface. And primitive data type divided into further two parts: numeric data type, non-numeric data type. Numeric data type, integer and real. Integer means integer type, byte, short, int, long, and real, float, and double. And non-numeric data type, char and boolean. There are these data type in Java. What is the meaning of garbage collection? Garbage collection is the mechanism that deallocate the memory of an object when it is no longer referenced by a variable. In C++, the memory of an object is released by use of delete operator. Java Virtual Machine determines when to free up memory of an object. That is the meaning of garbage collection. Advantage of Java. Java is a simple language. Java does not support pointers. Java is first language in which program can be executing using VAP and write once, run anywhere. And parallelly, advantage of OOPs over procedure oriented programming language. OOPs make development and maintenance easier, whereas in a procedure-oriented programming language, it is not easy to manage. If code grows, our project size increases. OOPs provide data hiding, whereas in a procedure-oriented programming language, global data can be accessed from anywhere. OOPs provide the ability to simulate real-world event much more effectively. We can provide the solution of real-world problem if we are using the object-oriented program. First, most important question, ask, what is the difference between an object-oriented programming language and object-based programming language? Anybody else? That is the answer is, object-based programming language follows all the features of OOP except inheritance. But JavaScript and VBScript are example of object-based programming language. It is clear? Disadvantage of Java. Slow performance. No support for low-level programming, poor features in Java, no control over garbage collection. We will discuss garbage collection. What is the meaning of the garbage collection? Garbage collection is the mechanism that deallocate the memory of an object is to no longer referenced by a variable. That is the meaning of the garbage collection. In C++, the memory and object of an object is released by use of delete operator. This is the internet mailing system project of the Java. User can send information and query to each other, provide the facility to maintain profile and inbox of each employee separately, develop a communication interface for the organization. This is the most important question for the introduction of Java. What is the difference between C++ and Java? So first of all, first difference, platform independent. C++ is platform dependent. Java is platform independent. Second, mainly used for C++, system programming. Java is mainly used for application programming. It is widely used in Windows, web-based, enterprise, and mobile application. Design goal comparison C++ and Java. C++ was designed for systems and application programming. It was an extension of C programming language. Java was designed and created as an interpreter for printing system, but later extended as a support network computing. It was designed with the goal of being easy to use and accessible to broader audiences. Difference between go to. So C++ support the go to statement. Java does not support the go to statement. Multiple inheritance. C++ support multiple inheritance. Java does not support multiple inheritance through class. It can be achieved by interface in Java. Operator overloading. C++ support operator overloading. Java does not support operator overloading. Pointers. C++ support pointers. You can write pointer program in C++. Java support pointer internally. However, you cannot write the pointer program in Java. It means Java has restricted pointer support in Java. Compiler and interpreter. C++ uses compiler only. C++ is compiled and run using the compiler, which converts source code into the machine code. So C++ is platform dependent. Java uses compiler and interpreter both. Java source code is converted into the bytecode at compilation time. The interpreter executes this bytecode at runtime and produce output. Java is interpreter, that is why it is platform independent. Call by value and call by reference. C++ support both call by value and call by reference. Java support call by value only. There is no call by reference in Java. Thank you.